Okay, kita sambung eh. Okay, now we move to ITS yang fokus untuk arterial and freeway management system eh. Yang tadi kita lihat ITS secara umum eh. Tapi yang ni kita lihat lebih spesifik. Maksudnya part yang betul-betul detail dan apa ni, application dia lah macam mana eh. Okay, arterial freeway management system atau saya kata dia AFMS. So kalau kita lihat dalam part ni kita akan fokus kepada traffic signal control system, system detector, closed circuit television, so CCTV cameras, RAN meters, VMS, bus probe. Jadi benda-benda ni yang secara langsung eh, yang sedia dipakai dan memang menjadi kebiasaan lah dalam freeway ataupun arterial. Okay, the goal eh, the goal of AFMS to improve traffic flow, increase safety, reduce cost, improve traveler experience. Dia macam yang tadi juga lah, macam ITS juga, macam TSM juga kan. Sebab benda tu correlate dan benda tu sama je kan. Cuma yang tadi lebih umum lah. Yang ni yang spesifik untuk keperluan pada arterial dan freeway. Kalau sebut istilah arterial ni, dia jalan di bandar. Jalan jalan perbandaran lah. Jalan di bandar-bandar yang besar. Kalau freeway ni expressway lah. Cuma ni istilah dekat US. Dia gunakan arterial dan freeway eh. Okey, kita lihat example ya. Adaptive signal control. Benda macam mana ni kan, adaptive signal control ni kan? Okay, adaptive signal control, system coordinate control traffic flow by continually adjusting signal timing parameter based on the current volume. Jadi, traffic light yang kita sedia ada, dia tak ada elemen adaptive signal control ni eh. Dia lebih lebih kepada free time ataupun pre-time, fixed time eh, fixed time and predetermined eh, time. Tapi adaptive signal control ni dia optimize lagi dari segi apa ni, kawalan dan juga bacaan ataupun data daripada traffic flow sendiri. Jadi dia, dia akan ada perubahan dari masa-masa untuk dia update dan proses. Jadi dia dia memerlukan sistem dan operasi secara advance lah. Jadi dia akan menggunakan sensor, processing dan juga tools untuk operate communicating traffic light lah. Dan kita lihat kat sini kan. So dia ada detection sini kan. Kemudian apa ni, dia ada control box kat sini. So ini semua radar ataupun detector lah yang diperlukan untuk menghasilkan apa ni, adaptive signal tu sini. Okay, how does it works? Okay, first dalam adaptive signal control ni dia ada traffic sensor eh, yang collect data eh. Okay, traffic data is evaluated and the timing improvement are developed. Jadi daripada sensor yang collect data ni, dia akan berlaku secara real time eh, ataupun dia akan punya masa sikit lah untuk di evaluate. Then adaptive signal control implement to the timing updates. Jadi benda ni akan berlaku secara simultaneously eh. Dia akan nampak ada dia punya proses tapi benda tu berlaku cepat eh. Okey, apakah faedah atau benefit eh, kalau, kalau kita guna adaptive signal control ni? Okay, dia akan mengurangkan travel times, delay pun boleh lagi dikurangkan. Boleh melibatkan apa ni, apa ni, konflik yang dikurang. Jadi bila konflik kurang ni, kemalangan pun boleh dikurangkan, diselamatkan. Traveler enjoy more reliable trip based on actual condition. Jadi benda-benda ni boleh meningkatkan lagi ya, keberkesanan dan efficiency of traffic signal sendiri ya. So kalau kita lihat ni dah sample eh. Thank you.
Traffic congestion is one of the most significant problems in cities rapidly growing due to increased population and urbanization rates. As a consequence, stress emerging due to air and noise pollution and fuel consumption makes city life more difficult. ISPAC, aiming to minimize these negative effects of traffic jams towards the environment and people, brought a new perspective to traffic management by courtesy of ATAK, which it has developed. Via ATAK, the number of vehicles in junctions is perceived by courtesy of the magnetic sensors placed at junctions. Magnetic sensors perceiving the number of vehicles send this data to traffic signal controllers located at the junction via signals. The traffic signal controller, receiving the number of vehicles information incoming from the sensors, instantly sends the information to the fully adaptive traffic management system located at the traffic control center. The fully adaptive traffic management system software, receiving the traffic density information at all junctions, generates suitable signalization times for all junctions through using real-time optimization methods and sends back the information to traffic signal controllers. By this means, the waiting time at junctions with high vehicle density is reduced. By courtesy of the fully adaptive traffic management systems developed by ISPAC, less waiting time in the traffic, shorter travel times, less fuel consumption, less spending for spare parts, and a cleaner environment.
Itu contoh pelaksanaan teknologi ataupun sistem adaptive signal control. Okay, next kita lihat yang kedua, traffic surveillance and monitoring. Okay, traffic surveillance system supply information about condition in the field and other system components that appropriate respond and control action to be taken. Jadi keadaan pengawasan trafik semasa perlu diketahui. Sebab benda ni menjadi data dan juga situasi sebenar. Jadi dari semasa ke masa, situasi ini perlu dimonitor dan diupdatekan kepada keperluan-keperluan tertentu untuk memastikan operasi facilities yang ada di highway dan juga di di bandar, terutamanya untuk pengangkutan lebih lancar. Monitoring and traffic surveillance safety include CCTV, system detector, communication network that help to improve incident management, information and control decision making, determine traffic condition for information dissemination. Jadi maklumat-maklumat ni akan diproses dan akan digunakan untuk membuat apa-apa perubahan. Jalan ni akan ditutup ataupun situasi sekarang ni berlaku, kemudian dia ada satu alternatif lain, ataupun maklumat ni dia akan dihebahkan kepada guna-pengguna atau pihak tertentu. Surveillance can be enhanced operation, preparation, planning by first detection and verify the incidents. Maksudnya kita dah kena pasti dan tahu apa yang berlaku. Monitoring incident clearance, monitoring traffic emergency and special events, monitoring traffic operation and supporting implementation control strategies, monitoring pavement and environment conditions, monitoring traffic operation then generate data and planning resource purposes. Jadi ini sebahagiannya yang kita perlukan dalam aktiviti surveillance dan monitoring ni. Dalam untuk collect data untuk surveillance dan monitoring ni, kita akan gunakan pelbagai teknologi dan devices, sensor, detector macam ni dengan radar macam ni menggunakan kamera vision untuk lihat kenderaan lalu lintas. Gunakan loop pada jalan sendiri garisan-garisan tu, kalau pasal ada sengaja jalan tu dia ada macam kotak-kotak garisan itu semua ada dah loop ataupun sensor Ada juga setengah yang letak apa ni peralatan yang ada komunikasi wireless ataupun wave atas jalan kan. Ditanam lah, underneath pavement tu lah. Okay, benefit of traffic surveillance and monitoring. First, reduce time travels, reduce delay, fewer stops, low gas emission, lower fuel consumption, quicker response, better management for traffic incidents, real-time traffic condition, detected of traffic violations. Ini pun satu kelebihan juga sebab dia real-time kan. Kalau ada buat kesalahan, traffic ataupun penjenayah sebagainya dapat detect. Okay, ini yang saya nak kongsikan untuk apa yang kita ada. Saya ingat di Malaysia lah, di Dewan Bandaraya Kuala Lumpur. Mungkin ada yang dah lihat video ni yang pernah ambil kursus dengan saya dalam apa ni, kursus BFC 3202. Tapi mungkin ada yang tak lihat lagi . Jadi yang dah lihat tu pun mungkin ingat-ingat lupa . Kita boleh tengok sekali lagi dah kot.
Being the premier city and the capital of the nation, Kuala Lumpur's mission is to become a world-class city, guided by the Kuala Lumpur Structure Plan 2020. There is a need to adopt new and improved traffic management measures aimed at optimizing the existing infrastructure to enhance flow capacity. It gives me great pleasure in knowing that ITIS has added several other traffic improvements to Kuala Lumpur as it strives to become a world-class city by the year 2020.
Kuala Lumpur is one of Southeast Asia's most modern and dynamic port system, or ITIS. The first stage is data collection. Data about traffic conditions is collected electronically from a range of sources. The second stage is processing of that information. The data is networked to a central computerized system where it is processed and analyzed. The third stage is dissemination of traffic information back to road users through a range of media. Video cameras have been installed at key roads and intersections throughout Kuala Lumpur to monitor traffic conditions. The cameras can be controlled remotely and provide continuous visual information of major roads within the city. Many of these cameras are programmed to detect abnormal traffic behavior and will automatically alert operators if an incident is detected. Incidents such as breakdowns and accidents can be detected in this way. Traffic behavior is also monitored by satellite tracking devices, which have been installed in over 1,000 vehicles to provide a comprehensive analysis of traffic flow.
Travel pattern, travel flow.
Processing of all the incoming traffic data is performed by a suite of sophisticated software and hardware called the Advanced Traffic Management System. This processing engine is the computerized heart of ITIS. The system integrates and controls all the data collection devices, such as CCTV cameras and satellite tracking devices, then processes, analyzes and interprets the data into useful information, enabling operators to take remedial actions and disseminate information back to commuters and road users. The system can also provide trend information and statistics about traffic behavior for research and development activities, traffic management strategies, and town planning. Traffic information is quickly delivered back to road users by various means. Drivers can view roadside signs called variable message signs that are located strategically throughout Kuala Lumpur's road system. These signs provide updated traffic information, advice and instructions for drivers. Drivers can also consult an ITIS internet service before traveling to get real-time information about traffic congestion, travel speed and traffic incidents. Drivers can also phone in and speak to an operator at the call center. Located at Bukit Jalil, Kuala Lumpur, the Transport Management Center was purpose-built to house the sophisticated systems which form the hub of ITIS. The Transport Management Center receives, processes, and disseminates traffic information to operators who monitor and manage Kuala Lumpur's traffic and the adjacent road networks covered under the ITIS system. The Simulation and Joint Operations Center is designed to mirror the Operations Center for management of special events. The Emergency Operations Center provides facilities for handling crises and major unscheduled traffic incidents. The Administration Center accommodates the management personnel in a modern, comfortable office environment. The Call Center is manned for 24-hour operations to provide traffic information to the public. The Server Network Operations Center is a mission-critical computer server installation that processes raw data from over 1,000 roadside cameras and devices. The ITIS system is able to detect a stationary vehicle parked on the side of a highway due to a breakdown or accident, triggering an alarm that will alert an operator at the traffic management center. Operators will decide on an appropriate response and contact the relevant authorities. Road users can then be advised about the incident. Sometimes road closures are necessary for planned events, such as a parade or a motorcade. The ITIS system can analyze and recommend the appropriate traffic diversions and can relay the information in advance. ITIS empowers commuters to make choices about traffic conditions, how and when to travel. It also benefits the commuting public in many ways. Access to real-time traffic information, improved traffic conditions, improved road safety, improved emergency response times, improved traffic incident management, reduced travel time, more effective road capacity. In the future, ITIS will function beyond the processing of traffic information. It will offer information services over mobile devices and radio, and will keep pace with new and emerging communications technologies. While ITIS presently covers all of Kuala Lumpur's road systems, eventually it will have nationwide coverage and will influence the future planning of Malaysia's roadways. ITIS, the clear way to go.
So, benda ni sebenarnya dah lama ada di Kuala Lumpur. Cuma dari segi pelaksanaan dan juga apa ni penambahbaikan dan sebagainya, dia akan tengok trend semasa sebab sistem yang ada tu sesuai untuk pada ketika dia establish tu Dia dah bermula daripada tahun 2004 saya rasa sistem yang dia buat. Okay, next kita ada RAM meterings. Itu apakah yang disebutkan RAM meterings? RAM meterings ataupun RAM susu keluar untuk ke highway atau masuk, biasa keluar lah yang ketika yang masuk tak ketika RAM ni maksudnya laluan yang kita nak keluar masuk, sama ada kita keluar highway atau masuk highway, tapi yang kritikalnya bila kita nak masuk tu Okay, RAM meter ni are signalized located at freeway on RAM, maksudnya akan diletak di situasi susu masuk di lebuh raya to control flow of vehicle onto freeway, terutamanya di situasi yang kesesakan melampau sehingga berlaku bottleneck dan sebagainya. Vehicle are allowed to enter freeway only on a green indication, maksudnya masa merah tak boleh masuk lah, kena tahan macam traffic tak biasa lah kan. Bila dah clear, ada dia punya gap, ada dia punya apa ni kelegaan traffic, maka dia akan lepaskan jadi hijau lah. This rate determined through either real time or historical knowledge on the freeway capacity and demand on ramp. Jadi untuk dia jadikan apa ni signalized ni beroperasi sebagaimana yang sepatutnya, maka sebagainya mungkin dia guna data-data yang sedia ada ataupun data yang di capture daripada pengesan ataupun detektor yang dipasang berhampiran dengan apa ni lawan masuk tu lah, bukan sini di highway tu sendiri. Ya, ni nampak tak ni? Okay, saat ni dia pasang dia punya detection, detector, loop detector. Kemudian kalau dia tengok kat sini heavy sangat, maka dia akan jadi kamera. Kalau dah lega kan, dia akan jadikan hijau kan. Jadi ini dia punya cara dia beroperasi lah. Okay, benefit of ride metering With ride meters, car enter in the control intervals they likely cause less likely to cause disruption on the highway, on the freeway. A short wait on the ramp allow driver to increase the average freeway speed and shorten for overall for freeway travels. Ini sebahagiannya, maksudnya laluan di highway itu menjadi lebih stable speed dan sebagainya lah. Ramp meter also reduce number of accident often occur on multiple vehicle merge onto the highway. Ini sebab yang titik yang kritikal titik-titik blind spot masa nak masuk ke highway tu, kadang kereta agak laju dan kita kadang-kadang terlepas pandang bahaya Ini kita tengok satu lagi video yang ringkas berkenaan ramp metering sendiri
Ramp meters are traffic signals placed at freeway on-ramps, which regulate the traffic entering a freeway by optimizing the use of available gaps for vehicles to merge. In addition to the traffic signal, a typical ramp meter design includes detector loops that feed information to the ramp meter controller, monitor the level of traffic, and detect gaps in the traffic stream. Loops are also installed on the on-ramp to monitor on-ramp traffic. Finally, an end-of-queue loop is placed at the entrance of the on-ramp to prevent backups onto local streets by releasing the queue when the ramp fills to capacity. The metering rate varies and depends on a combination of the level of congestion on the freeway and the number of vehicles waiting on the ramp. So why meter traffic? Experience with ramp meters in the Bay Area and elsewhere in the country has shown safety, travel time, speed, throughput, and environmental benefits. Ramp metering smooths out the flow of traffic by balancing conflicting traffic demands. A smoother traffic flow is safer, with less merging and weaving traffic. Collisions are reduced by up to 50%. Reduced congestion also improves air quality. And adjacent city streets benefit as well, because fewer drivers seek alternate routes.
Itu bahagian apa ni penggunaan ramp meter di highway Okay, information dissemination dissemination maksudnya hebahan maklumat ataupun informasi kepada pengguna Okay, traffic information is conveyed to motorists through different means such as dynamic messaging system maksudnya dia akan berubah-ubah dari segi keperluan ataupun variable message system. Benda ni display untuk memberi maklumat yang pengguna rasa dia perlu tahu dan dia perlu buat tindakan tertentu Dia lebih kurang je ni keadaan dia, cuma ada yang kekal di situ dan ada yang bergerak. Dynamic ni maksudnya dia letak di satu kawasan, nanti dia boleh pindah, kadang-kadang gunakan kenderaan, dia gunakan benda yang sementara lah. Tapi yang VMS ni, benda ni dia kekal dia letak kat situ macam gantry sebagainya untuk makluman kepada apa ni pengguna lah. Okay, this one is typical dynamic message sign kan. Dia bukannya kekal ni, dia nanti dia boleh berubah, dia boleh dipindahkan. Buat masa ni inilah dia punya peletakan dia Okay, contain information constantly change due to actual condition. This information include travel time, weather and speed. Okay, variable message sign, static message can be changed through the center operations. Okay, benda ni dia letak kekal dan apa yang ada kat sini dikawal oleh center. Macam yang ni dia dah default lah kan, maksudnya dia akan bawa lah alat dia nak setting ni. kan, dia buat awal nak setting, kemudian dia akan macam ni, memang dia ada control center dia untuk beri makluman kepada kenderaan eh, termasuk variable speed macam ni kan. Ada yang diubah-ubah variable speed ni, ada yang dikekalkan. Okay, benefit of dynamic and variable messaging system, provide information to travelers that may enhance their driving safety impact behaviors, travel time saving due to diversion to alternative route in the event of the traffic congestion and incidents, effective as a tool route guidance and is able to increase driver diversion rate significantly when required. So benda ni dia akan interact dengan drivers ni. So driver dapatkan hebahan ini, maksudnya makluman ini, maka dia akan buat keputusan dan dia akan memanfaatkan maklumat ini lah. So ini video klip yang saya rasa menarik untuk dilihat lah berkenaan dengan VMS ni.
Variable message signs. Detect and interpret traffic lights and speed limits in simulations for autonomous driving. Sensor-based autonomous driving requires the detection and interpretation of variable message signs and traffic lights. The sensor of the autonomous vehicle detects when the traffic light turns green. It interprets the change correctly, and the vehicle starts driving. Fully autonomously. The sensor can also detect a traffic control system attached to a gantry. It can distinguish between individual speed limits for different lanes. The sensor interprets a change of the displayed speed limit and associates this change to the relevant lanes. The vehicle controls adapt to the new speed limit. The Automotive Simulation Models Tool Suite, ASM, supports the detection and interpretation of variable message signs during autonomous driving simulations.
So itu sebahagian komunikasi antara apa ni, VMS dengan kenderaan itu sendiri daripada kenderaan autonomous . Jadi mungkin di masa akan datang, mungkin dah ada pun teknologi tu kan, mungkin belum sampai kepada kita . Komunikasi antara infra di jalan raya, di lebuh raya ni lebih cekap. Mereka tak bergantung semata-mata satu komunikasi saja, tapi itu komunikasi . Okay, now we look focus on ITS, on traffic management, transit management system . Kalau tadi kita lihat ITS kat jalan raya, arterial or highway, this one transit for apa ni, ITS for transit management system . So kalau kita lihat kat sini, antara pembahagiannya kita ada automatic vehicle locations, AVL, computer aided dispatch, transit signal priority, traveler information system . So ini semua nak menyokong advanced public transportation system . Sebab sekarang kita lihat ke transit . Yang tadi kita fokus kepada infra ataupun road network di lebuh raya dan juga di jalan perbandaran . So advanced public transport system or APTS seek to apply transport management and information technologies to public transit system to increase their efficiency operation and improve the safety of the public transportation riders . Jadi kita sendirilah yang menjadi pengguna . Masuk riders ni, kita lah pengguna . Okay, first kita lihat automatic vehicle location . Okay, automatic vehicle location or AVL involve the use of computer tracking devices, dispatch and tracking transit vehicle. Jadi penting . Sebab kita nak tahu kedudukan kenderaan, contohnya bus ni kan, transit ni bagaimana dia punya operasi dia kan, schedule dia dah macam mana kan, dari segi operasi dia lah. Dan penting kita kena tahu kan. Okay, AVL system made up to two components, location technology dan data transmission technology. So dalam location technology ni kita ada sign post and odometer dan juga GPS. Maksudnya ini kaedah yang kita nak guna dan nak kawal dan nak tahu. Okay, juga kita ada radio navigation, that road marking. Okay, next kita ada computer aided dispatch. The computer aided dispatch software integrate transit operations by giving transit dispatcher and supervisor decision support tools to manage operating environments. Decision support recommend include vehicle headway, dispatch replacement or additional vehicle or reporting incident. Jadi dia macam komunikasi dengan driver bus, operator apa ni, operator machine atau bus vehicle ni dengan center lah, center control rooms, supaya dia tahulah situasi yang diperlukan dan juga performance atau operation bus sendiri lah. Okay, benefit of AEVAL and CAD: increased schedule assurance, able to monitor bus performance, driver performance, reduce response to operational problems. Dispatcher are able to communicate better and monitor large fleets. Passenger perceive service as modern and reliable due to availability of real-time information. Improve safety and security. So macam dia cover banyak angle lah, banyak scope, sama ada di pihak pengurusan, di pihak driver tu sendiri dan juga di pihak pengguna lah. Ini satu pelaksanaan AVL vehicle. Cuma ini di negara Arab lah, tapi negara Arab ni pun sebagainya dah ada advance. Kalau dekat apa ni, UAE, Dubai, Qatar, dia sangat advance dia punya sistem dia.
Vehicle tracking has been in the market for a long time. Today, corporates not just want to track vehicles, but also would like to manage them to save cost, time, and efforts on the overall fleet. AVL tracking system from FRI offers very efficient solution tailored for your business. By using AVL, you can easily track and monitor your vehicles, monitor the directions, evaluate your drivers, monitor the speed, reduce fuel consumption, and get notifications with maintenance services. The system collects data from various sensors and sends data to our system to manage and control all data. That's why the system is widely used in constructions, education, food and beverage, government, manufacturing, oil and gas, service providers, transportation, trucking and waste management industries. FRT will give you limitless and precise control of your vehicles from hundreds of miles away through eliminating unnecessary extra trips and reduce costs, reducing your manpower expenses while boosting your efficiency, improving your customer service by offering them fast and accurate answers to their questions, making wiser decisions by knowing where your team members are at any time, detecting the real-time vehicle status, following each unit or multi-unit on the map, the availability to show how a vehicle moved during indicated period with date and time. We have used the latest trends of tracking technologies in order to provide zero compromise towards safety and security. AVL tracking system allows user to easily monitor the fleet work, know all details about the vehicles by just building report templates, and the system will send all reports automatically to predefined email address in a predefined schedule. Visit our website to check all AVL system features and request your demo now. Get maximum value from your tracking data.
Itu sistem AAV yang ada kat luar negara. Okay, next, transit signal priority. Transit signal priority is operation strategy that facilitate the movement of vehicle to the signal control intersections to improve schedule and adherence, to improve transit travel time efficiency. Maksudnya dia akan keutamaan diberikan kepada setengah-setengah apa ni operasi kenderaan tu, mungkin melibatkan kenderaan public, mungkin melibatkan kenderaan emergency, mungkin melibatkan kenderaan yang high occupancy vehicle. Jadi itu kelebihan dia. Jadi transit signal priority ni, kalau kita lihat, dia ada 4 elemen utama. Transit vehicle, transit fleet management, traffic control and traffic control management. So dia akan ada subdivision atau subsystem lagi untuk detect vehicle, untuk priority jenis vehicle, untuk apa priority request server and implementation of DSP itu sendiri lah. Macam mana dia berfungsi? Pertama sekali dia akan detect, man detect kenderaan, approaching the intersection. Kemudian dia akan request priority, mana kenderaan ni layak tak ataupun masuk dalam kategori tak. Kemudian dia akan integrate lah dengan apa ni phasing dan timing untuk grid time. Dan bila kenderaan tu dah clear intersection, kemudian dia akan normal kepada operation biasa. The benefit of signal priority system ni, transit signal priority ni, significant reduction in intersection delays, travel time saving, increased schedule adherence and reliability of service, increased ridership and passenger satisfactions, reduced number of vehicle required to operate. So ini pun tayangan yang menarik juga dalam klip ni yang kita boleh tengok dan kita tahulah sistem ni macam mana. Okay, dalam simulasi ni boleh tengok tak? Okay, bila bar datang kan, yang kali hijau tu maksudnya green time kan? Mana yang tak ada bar tu, dia stop kan? Cuma kalau bar bila kat belakang, macam contoh yang ni kan, bar kat belakang ni kan dia tak dapat detect dah jauh kan? Tapi kalau ada bar dekat heading ni, maka dia akan bagi priority. Contoh ni kan, ni bar kan? Dia datang ni, dia akan detect, dia akan beri green light lah, ataupun green time lah. Dan ni tak ada apa-apa maka masa dia tak boleh sebab bas ni dia tak nampak jauh jadi dia tak dapat detect lah sebab dia ada sensor dia tu taklah jauh sangat dia letak kan bila approaching tu baru dia akan priority kan kenderaan tertentu yang dah digazetkan ataupun dikategoriskan sebagai transit signal priority lah. Jadi saya kata tadi lah mungkin ada yang menyebabkan bas, menyebabkan emergency vehicle, rescue vehicle kan. Okay, faham kan? Bila bas dah pergi, maka dia akan operate macam biasa lah. Macam yang normal punya setting lah. Okay, the last one, Traveller Information System. Okay, Traveller Information System provide transit user to with information about more and apa ni? One or more mode of transport. This information can provide pre-trip and routes. The user may access information at home, work, terminal transport, wayside stop, onboard vehicle and various technology. Even kita boleh install kita punya journey planner ke ataupun apa-apa app. Sekarang banyak app. Jadi benda ni memberi kita satu panduan dan maklumat untuk kita plan kita punya perjalanan kita Okay, travel information system, kita ada tiga komponen yang utama iaitu general info, schedule info dan operational info Untuk general info ni macam-macam lah. Ada transport service, major road, attraction, information agency. Kalau schedule road, fare, schedule untuk apa ni, perjalanan bus tu lah. Bus stop, location map. Kalau operational info, real time lah kan. Berapa masa perjalanan, bila sampai, delay macam mana, berapa jumlah penumpang, kesesakan sebagainya lah. Okay, yang quite common yang kita ada, yang kita boleh access smartphone kita, tablet dan based on internet connection dan dia punya retrieve data daripada penyedia teknologi tu lah. Okay, ini pun yang common lah kita ada tempat yang kita boleh dapatkan maklumat, kita kios sebagainya. Sekarang pun dah ada inovasi iaitu map apa ni MRT ataupun LRT tu boleh di-scan secara augmented reality kan, augmented reality ada kan yang viral tu. Itu pun satu teknologi yang kita kata bawah travel information system. kan ini yang display daripada transit sendiri kan, dalam kita tahu kan kat mana kita nak sampai, berapa jam lagi atau berapa minit lagi lah, biasanya kalau dekat-dekat berapa minit lah kan. Okay, ini satu apa ni, ITS pelaksanaan yang kuat komprehensif lah di luar negara eh.
Are you ready for the next generation of transportation? Where it's not just about getting from point A to point B, but getting there in a safer, greener, and more convenient way. Thanks to Intel architecture, that future isn't far away. By connecting and distributing intelligent Intel processors inside vehicles and throughout the transportation infrastructure, we can transform transportation in profound and unimaginable ways. Intelligent travel will be multimodal, enhancing all forms of transportation, whether by car, rail, or air. And travelers will be able to remain seamlessly connected across every means of travel. Let's take a closer look. Your future vehicle will be equipped with an Intel Atom processor, delivering the processing headroom to perform many tasks simultaneously, such as improving navigation, communication, and passenger entertainment, all while enabling safer, more efficient travel. Your car will be able to connect over a variety of wireless standards to the internet, to intelligent traffic systems, and even to other vehicles. Essentially, your car becomes just another extension of your digital lifestyle. Imagine downloading music, movies, and TV shows from the cloud. Want directions? Just ask. You'll get routing information complete with rich visual maps and satellite imagery. And your passengers can even mark points of interest to make stops along the way. When your fuel level or battery power start to get low, your vehicle will automatically search for fuel or recharging stations, providing directions to those with the lowest prices. Sensors inside and outside your vehicle will also improve safety. Inside, cameras could recognize driver and passengers and adapt seating, navigation, and entertainment preferences to match. Outside, sensors will detect lane departures, sense and respond to potential dangers, such as not slowing down for an upcoming stop sign, and continually identify objects in front, beside, or behind you to avoid collisions, assist in parking, or allow your cruise control to adapt speed to maintain a safe distance from the car in front of you. Connected intelligence will extend beyond vehicles. Existing and emerging wireless standards will enable vehicles and devices across the transportation infrastructure to communicate with each other, enabling automated, intelligent, real-time decisions to optimize travel. For example, strategically placed safety cameras will identify congestion or accidents, automatically alerting emergency personnel, as well as rerouting traffic by notifying approaching vehicles and updating nearby digital roadside signs. Intelligent traffic lights will become more prevalent and smarter than today, detecting real-time traffic flow from each direction and automatically changing signals to improve traffic flow. Distributed intelligence that is secure and reliable is the key, transforming the entire traffic infrastructure from being passive and unaware to a proactive, intelligent, connected sense and respond system that improves travel in every way. And building that infrastructure on an existing, pervasive, standards-based architecture is paramount to making this transportation vision a reality.
So, kalau lihat tayangan ni macam, oi, tak terjangkau eh. Sedangkan video ni dah dibuat lama. Saya tengok kat YouTube pun, saya ingat dah 2014 macam tu eh. Dua benda ni semua dah berlaku sekarang eh. Cuma mungkin tak menyeluruh ataupun sebahagiannya memang tempat tu ada, sebagainya memang belum laksanakan lagi, mungkin dalam bentuk apa ni commercialize sebagainya, tapi dah ada eh, benda tu dah ada. Saya rasa itu sahaja untuk kuliah pada hari ini. Kita boleh apa ni berhenti untuk slide ni, dan nanti kita akan sambung sedikit masa lagi dalam apa ni classroom eh. Saya dah ada muat naik satu aktiviti dekat Google Classroom lah. Saya lepas ni pelajar boleh terus ke Google Classroom eh. Okey, untuk hari ini kita boleh berhenti setakat ini. Sekian, terima kasih untuk pelajar semua. Terus pergi ke Google Classroom untuk dapatkan maklumat terkini.